we are going to compute the main engine RPM, distance, and slip. So first, we have to compute the revolution per minute of the engine. So this is revolution counter present minus revolution counter previous. So we have to read the counter revolution on the counter revolution meter, or either it is an digital or it is analog. So revolution counter present minus revolution counter previous is equals to total counter revolution divided by engine hours propelled. So ano itong engine hours propelled? Ito yung tinakbo ng barko natin, regardless kung from noon to arrival or noon to noon. So this is in minutes. So we have to convert the hours to minute. For example, the engine ran for 24 hours. So 24 hours times 60. 1 hour is equals to 60 minutes. So this is the example. Revolution per minute of the engine is equals to, this is the counter revolution of present, 12695 1650, minus 12680 3770, which is, this is the previous counter revolution, is equals to 147880. This is the total counter revolution divided 1440 minutes or 24 hours run, because 1 hour is equals to 60 minutes. So 24 times 60 is equals to 1440 minutes. So the RPM that we get is equals to 102 RPM. So this is our RPM, 102.7 RPM. So now we have already an RPM. So next that we are going to compute is the distance. So here, main engine distance is equals to speed times time. We have here the RPM, but we don't have the speed. We also have the time, which is the 24 hours. So we have to compute the speed. Speed is equals to RPM times propeller constant. We don't have a propeller constant, so we have to compute the propeller constant. So this is the procedure on how to compute the propeller constant. So propeller constant is equals to propeller pitch, or pitch of propeller in meter. So where we can find this pitch propeller? We usually can see this pitch of propeller in ship's particular or vessel particular handbook or manual. We can find it there, the propeller pitch. Times 60 minutes over 1852 meter. What is this 1852 meter? This is 1 nautical mile per hour. So the equivalent of 1 nautical mile per hour is equals 1852 meter, because right here we have to, we are using here meter to hour. 60 minutes is equals to 1 hour. So this is the example. For example, the pitch of propeller of this vessel is 4.317 meters. So times 60 over 1852 is equals to 0.13985. So this is our propeller constant. So anyway, Kabaro, what is pitch of propeller? This is the usual question new graduate. So as I can remember, this is one of the question to me by the chief engineer when I passed the Marina Scholarship Program. So, propeller pitch. What is pitch of propeller? So, pitch of propeller, Kabaro, this is the distance traveled by a vessel in one revolution. Just for example, the pitch of propeller is 4.317 meter. So, in one revolution, of the propeller in 360 degrees, this is the distance where the vessel goes. So, from point here, where the vessel stop, in one revolution, it travels 4.317 meter. So, that is the propeller pitch or pitch of propeller. So, we go back here. So, this is our propeller constant, 4.317 meter times 60 or 1 hour over 1852 or 1 nautical mile per hour is equals to 0.13985. So, this is our propeller constant. We will go back right here. So, we can compute now the speed. So, speed is equals to RPM times propeller constant. So, 102.7 is RPM times 0.13985 is equals to 14.36 knots or nautical mile per hour. So, we have now the speed, 14.36. We can compute now the engine distance. Engine distance is equals to 14.36 speed times 24, which is the 24 hours run. So, 14.36 nautical mile per hour times 24 hour here. So, you have to cancel the hour. The hour is canceled. So, the remaining is nautical mile. So, 14.36 times 24 is equals to 344.64 nautical miles. So, this is our engine distance. This is the engine distance, 344.64. So, now we have to go to compute the slip. So, what is slip? Slip is equals to engine distance. This is the distance of an engine minus actual distance. So, what is this actual distance? This is the actual distance that traveled by a vessel affected by external forces like wind, current, and waves. So, actual distance, or we call it OG or overground. So, we take this distance on the bridge. This distance was given by the bridge officer during noon time or arrival time. So, engine distance, for example, is 300 miles. So, we took this 300 miles on the bridge. This was given by the deck officers. So, engine distance minus actual distance over engine distance times 100% is equals to slip. So, actually, slip determines the factors that affect the engine distance. If the slip is higher, we can determine that we have a bad weather or we have a bad external forces that affects the engine distance traveled by the main engine. Just for example, we have slip more than 10%. So, on this, we can determine that we have a bad weather that affects the engine distance. So, the higher the slip, meaning there is a bad weather that affects the vessel. So either there is a strong wind strong current, tapos the running condition of the vessel, and big waves. How about if we have negative slip? So, if we have negative slip, we can determine that we have a good weather. The current is pushing the vessel to move forward and add on the engine speed. Or the wave is pushing the vessel to add a speed to the engine. So, for example, right here, slip. Our engine distance is 344.64 miles. 344.64 minus 300 miles. This is the actual miles over 344.64 times 100 is equals to 12.96%. So this is the slip. So we can determine here that supposed to be the engine distance that we are going to travel is 344.64 miles. But the actual miles that run by the vessel is only 300. And therefore, we have some external forces that prevent the vessel on gaining this engine distance or more speed to gain this distance. So either we have a strong current or we have a strong wind that opposes the vessel speed. That's why this is also one of the important factor that we compute on board, because some of the charterer and the owner always look at this slip. They determine that if the slip is higher, then we have a bad weather or some external forces that opposing the vessel speed. But if the vessel is negative, as I can explain, then we have a good weather or the current is pushing the vessel to gain more speed. So that's all for the main engine RPM, distance, and slip. So now, Kabaro, we will compute the main engine power and main engine load percentage based on fuel oil consumption. So right here, the formula is main engine power is equals to FM or flow meter times correction of specific gravity times calorific value times 1000 divided by 10,200 or base calorific value times specific fuel oil consumption at sea trial. So here, just for example, here is the given FM or main engine flow meter for 1 hour. So you have to take the main engine flow meter for 1 hour. Just for example, you have consumption for 24 hours. You have to divide the consumption in 24 to take the 1 hour consumption in liters. If the flow meter is in cubic meter, you have to multiply it in 1000 so that you can get the liters consumption in 1 hour. So for example, our consumption for 1 hour is 1200 liters. So this is just only an example. Our correction specific gravity is 0.91. We are using 0.91 specific gravity. CV or calorific value. Fuel calorific value in kilocalorie per kilogram. So that means this is energy. So 1 megajoule per kilogram is equals to 239.01 kilocalorie per kilogram. For example, we have 41.36 megajoule kilogram. So this 4.36 megajoule per kilogram, where we can find this? So we can find this in laboratory result of our fuel. Its fuel has own calorific value. So this is example, this is the calorific value of the fuel. 4.36 megajoule per kilogram is equals to 9885.45 kilocalorie per kilogram. So you have to multiply 4.36 times 239.01 in order to get the kilocalorie value. So here the next one is the SFOC. SFOC is specific fuel consumption. This means that we have to take the specific fuel consumption of an engine at sea trial. So where we can find this? At the sea trial manual. So you have to find the sea trial manual on board. So just for example, our sea trial specific fuel consumption is 123.5 grams per PS per hour. And then 10,200. What is this 10,200? Here below, this 10,200 is base calorific value. This is constant. That means that this will not change. This is constant. So that is part of the formula, the constant, 10,200. The other one is 1,000 here. This is also constant, 1,000. So this value cannot be changed. That is constant. So we are using here, Kabaro, the formula in actual. I'm using this formula as an actual value of the whole laboratory results and specific fuel consumption. So here, MEP or main engine power equals 1,200. Which is our FM or kilometer, 0.91, correction specific gravity, 9885.45 kilocalorie per kilogram. This is our calorific value times 1,000 over divided by 10,200 times 123.5 specific fuel consumption. So right here, we have to compute the power in PS or field start or metric brake horsepower. Metric brake horsepower or field stock is the same. 1,200 times 0.91 times 969.16. So how do we come out with 969.16? So this is a shortcut in order not to lengthen the number, because if you multiply it one by one, it is very long to the calculator. You cannot get a value unless you have some multiple digital calculator. So I only shortcut it. So 9885.45 times 1,000 divided 10,200 is equals to 969.16. So I put it in shortcut. Again, 9885.45 times 1,000 over 10,200 is equals to 969.16. So, this is it now. 1,200 times 0.91 times 969.16 over 123.5 is equals to, here, 105,832.468 over 123.5 is equals to 8569 PS or field start. Then we have to compute it in kilowatts. So field start or metric brake horsepower is equals to 0.735 kilowatts. So 8569 times 0.735 is equals to 6298 kilowatts. So this is our main engine power, 6298 kilowatt. So right here in the other side, Kabaro, as can you see, I put it here, Japanese ISO standard, the another shortcut formula. So this is the Japanese International Standard Organization formula. So they put it in shortcut. So FM or flow meter times SG or specific gravity, corrected specific gravity times 941.18 over specific oil consumption at sea trial. So as can you see, Kabaro, I have here 969.16. But here in ISO standard, we have here 941.18. So a little bit difference. I put this 1,200 times 0.91 times 0.941.18. The value has small difference, but I think it is tolerable. So did they come out with this 941.18? So this is constant base calorific value as per ISO standard. Meaning, the calorific value of the fuel times 1,000 over 10,200. So this is their standard value, 941.18. So if you compute, if you're using this formula, also it is okay if you're using this formula. There is a little bit difference, but I think it is tolerable. Sometimes, if you don't know the calorific value of your fuel, then you can use this kind of formula. This is as per Japanese ISO standard. So we can use this formula. But if you want a very specific and detailed computation, you have to use this other formula. So in my own, I prefer to use this one because it is very detailed. So I have to find the calorific value of my fuel in lab analysis. So here, how to compute the load percentage? So it is very easy. Load percentage is equals to actual load over MCO 100% times 100. So for example, our actual power is 6298, and this is the 100 maximum continuous output of our engine. It's 650 at 100%. So 6298 over 8650 times 100 is equals to 72.81%. So meaning this 8650, this value is, we can find it in the ship's particular or in the main engine nameplate. This is the maximum continuous output 100% power of our engine. So, the actual power that we take, 6298 over 8650 times 100%, then we get the 82.81% load of our engine. So that is for the main engine power and load computation. So Kabaro, this is one example of my auto compute formula in Excel, Microsoft Excel. So if you know how to use the Microsoft Excel, then you can make this. It made your life more easier on board. So I think it is not hard to make this auto formula in Excel. Or if you don't know how to make a formula in Excel, then you can ask some of your colleague on board to make you this auto compute formula. So just for example here, I can compute all my non-reports details or items in just a minute. So I will just put my RS propelled here, my revolution counter, then I have here the automatic total and the RPM speed, main engine distance. That is a automatic formula. So if I put here the LG or overground distance or actual distance, automatic it will give me a slip. So, as well as here in the main engine power, as can you see, my main engine power is auto formula also. So, in just a minute, I can make my non-report.
as well as here the MCO percentage or load. I will just put the flow meter of main engine and generator and boiler here, and then all are automatic. It can give me here the consumption of main engine, auxiliary engine and boiler, and the total consumption. So here in the total consumption, automatic also my ROB will come out from the previous ROB. This is the previous ROB, then this is my total consumption. Automatic my ROB of fuel will generate. So also here in diesel, in cylinder oil, for example, I'll just put here the consumption per day, and then I will have here the ROB of the cylinder oil. Also in generator and main engine log, I forgot to mention that our ROB in cylinder oil, main engine system oil, and generator system oil are in liters, while our fuel and diesel are in metric ton.
So that's all, Kabaro. I hope that you learn and get some idea on this video. Thank you for sharing and subscribing my YouTube channel and my Facebook page. Sa mga hindi pa nag-like and subscribe, please like and subscribe my YouTube channel. Please click the link below. This is Chief Engineer Eldritch, and this is my vlog.